Thank you, Jesus. We bless you, Abba Father. Thank you, Jesus. We bless you, Abba Father. We celebrate you. We adore you. We give you all the glory. We give you all the honor. Be thou exalted in the name of Jesus. People of God, you are invited. Please invite your friends, your family members to join this live service. I welcome you once again to this new month that God has given us. God kept you and I alive to see today. He's worthy of our praise. Him alone is worthy. Him alone is worthy. Hallelujah. Praise God. Amen and amen. Please, people of God, let's appreciate God for His mercies, for His grace, for His goodness upon our lives in the name of Jesus. Wherever you are, wherever you are joining me, I would love you to lift up your voice, just being to appreciate God, just celebrating for another new month. Today is the first Sunday of the month of October. He has been faithful. He has been awesome. Father, we thank you. Lord, we bless you. We adore you, Abba Father. We celebrate you, Jehovah Nissi, Jehovah Jireh. You, we are grateful. Oh, Lord, we are grateful, Lord. Oh, we are grateful, oh, Lord. Hallelujah. For all you have done for us. Hallelujah. We are grateful, oh Lord. We are grateful, Lord. Oh, we are grateful, oh Lord. We are grateful, Lord. Oh, we are grateful, oh Lord. Hallelujah. For all you have done for us. Oh, we are grateful, oh Lord. You are worthy, Lord. Oh, you are worthy, Lord. You are worthy, Lord. Oh, worthy to be praised. You are worthy, Lord. Worthy, worthy. You are worthy, Lord. Oh, you are worthy, Lord. Worthy to be praised. El Shaddai, you are worthy, Lord. You are worthy. You are worthy, Lord. King of kings, you are worthy, Lord. Worthy to be praised. You are worthy, Lord. Worthy, worthy. You are worthy, Lord. You are worthy, Lord. Oh, worthy to be praised. You are worthy, Lord. Daddy, you are worthy, Lord. You are worthy, Lord. Oh, worthy to be praised. Shaddai, you are worthy, Lord. You are worthy. You are worthy, Lord. King of kings, you are worthy, Lord. Worthy to be praised. I will lift your name higher. I will lift your name higher. I will lift your name higher. Above other name, I will lift your name higher, higher. Lift your name higher. I will lift your name higher. Above other name, I will lift Jesus higher. I will lift Jesus higher. I will lift Jesus higher. Above other name, I will lift your name higher. I will lift your name higher. I will lift your name higher. Above other name. Father, I will lift your name higher. Lord, we celebrate you. We adore you. We celebrate you because there is no like this. There is no to be compared unto thee. Thank you for your mercy. Thank you for your glory upon us. Thank you, O God, for your mighty hand of preservation. Thank you, O God, for your gloriousness in our lives. We can't do without you, O God. Without you, we can do nothing. In a time like this, we choose to bless you. In a time like this, we adore you. Thank you, Abba Father. Thank you, King of Glory. In Jesus' name we pray. Hallelujah. People of God, wherever you are, I would love you to begin to plead the blood of Jesus upon your life. has the blood of Jesus to speak for you in this new month of October. Just begin to speak the blood of Jesus. Say, blood of Jesus, speak for me in this new month. I can't speak for myself, but you can speak for me. You can speak for me in all way around, in every area of my life, in my family, in my household, in my marriage, in my ministry. Lord, let your blood speak for me. Open your mouth and begin to pray. Begin to pray, begin to pray. Tell God that his blood is sufficient for you. His blood is sufficient. Let his blood speak for you in the name of Jesus Christ. Lord, King of glory, in this new month we have entered, in this month of October, may your blood speak for me. In my going out, in my coming in, Lord, let your blood speak. In all that I do, Jehovah Nissi, Jehovah Yireh, Lord, let your blood speak. The Bible said the blood of Jesus speak better things than the blood of Abel. Lord, may your blood speak for me. Let your blood speak. Let your blood speak. Let your blood speak for every of our viewers. Let your blood speak for every of our ministry. In the name of Jesus Christ, Lord, we thank you. We bless you. We adore you, Lord Jesus Christ. We celebrate you in the name of Jesus Christ. In Jesus' name we are praying. Amen. In Jesus' name we pray. Please, before we move ahead, I would love you to pray this prayer for yourself. When you open your Bible in the book of Ezekiel, chapter 34, verse 1, listen to the word of God. Ezekiel 34, verse 1, it says, "And the word of God came unto me, saying, Son of man," verse 2, "son of man, prophesy against the shepherd of Israel, prophesy and say unto them," hallelujah, people of God, you must understand the power of prophecy. You must understand the power of prophecy. So what I would love you to do for yourself this hour, you are going to prophesy upon your own life. Amen. It's not enough for your pastor, your bishop, your prophet to prophesy upon your life. It's also needful for you to prophesy upon your whole life. What you want to see in your life, what you want to see in your domain, around you, in your household, in your family, in the life of your loved one, you too, you have the power, you have the capacity to prophesy, and you will see them begin to walk out for your good. You will see them begin to walk out for your good. So this hour, wherever you are going to pray and say, Lord Jesus Christ, in the name of this that is above every other name, I prophesy upon my life. I don't know what you want. I don't know what you want to see. But begin to open your mouth and begin to speak those things into existence. Begin to speak those things into existence. Begin to prophesy upon your life what you want to see. Prophecy is the reality of what you want to see. Prophecy is a reality of what will come upon your life in time to come. In the name of Jesus. Holy Spirit of God, I prophesy upon my life. I prophesy upon my household. I prophesy upon my ministry. I prophesy upon those that is around me. Lord, this month of October, what they could not do before, Lord, may them begin to do that from the beginning of this moment in the name of Jesus Christ. Jehovah Nissi, Jehovah Jireh, I speak favor upon my life. I speak favor upon my household. I speak favor in my ministry. I speak favor in all that is around me in the name of Jesus Christ. Lord, from this now upwards, may the blessings of God begin to rain upon me. May the blessings of Lord begin to shower himself upon my domain in the name of Jesus Christ. Yes, children of God, prophesy upon your life. Prophesy upon your life. Is it marriage you want God to institute for you? Is it marriage you want God to work out for you? You have the capacity to prophesy and it will come to pass. Is it the area of finance? Begin to prophesy. Begin to prophesy. The Bible said, all things work together for good, for they that love God and for they that is called according to his purpose. God has called you not to shame you, but God has called you to glorify you. God has called you to beautify your life. So you have the mandate, the capacity, the audacity to speak and come into existence. You have the power to speak and you will see the result of what you are seeing, of what you have said with your man. The Bible said in the book of Genesis chapter 1, from verse 1, the Bible said, "And in the beginning, God created the heaven and the earth. And the earth was without form and void. And darkness was upon the surface of the deep. And the Spirit of God began to move upon the water." And verse 3 says, "And God said, let there be light." If you read further in many
chapter, in many verses. And God said, and God said, and God said, and God said, when you enter Deuteronomy, and the Bible said, and God saw. In other words, what you are saying always is what you will begin to see. So prophesy upon your life. Don't wait for your man of God to prophesy. Don't wait for your pastor to prophesy. You have all it takes to prophesy upon your marriage. You have all it takes to prophesy, upon your children. You have what it takes to prophesy upon anything that is not pleasant, that you want God to turn around. So, child of God, wherever you are, prophesy, prophesy, prophesy. Professor, begin to prophesy. Begin to prophesy. Begin to prophesy. If you want a change of life, prophesy now. Prophesy now. And God that is not asleep, God that is here, is always open to hear the prayer, to always hear the word of his children, will turn the table around for your good. It will turn the situation around for your good. In the name of Jesus Christ. Mazuda legadaba rigadaba shada gadaya. Rigadozo doba legadia. In the name of Jesus Christ, yes, professor, professor, professor. Professor, professor, the Bible said, and God was speaking to Ezekiel. He said, professor upon the dry bone, professor upon the dry bone, and they will become a living stock. And the Bible said, and Ezekiel professor in Ezekiel 37, he professor unto the dry bone, and they become a living soul. I don't know what is dead around you. I don't know what is not working around you. But in the name of Jesus, as above every other name, I speak unto your life this hour. Every dead thing around your life, whatsoever situation that is dead, whatsoever thing that is not making progress, that is not making wave, oh God, I prophesy in the life of your children this hour, oh God, let everything that is dead around them come back to life. Let everything that is dead around them, let them come back to life now. In the name of Jesus Christ. Yes, let them come back. Let them come back. By the power of the Holy Ghost. We thank you. We bless you. We adore you, Abba Father. We celebrate you, our Maker. We give you all the glory. We give you all the honor. In Jesus' most wonderful name, we pray. Amen. Hallelujah. We declare the service open in the name of the Father, of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. In Jesus' name, we have prayed. Amen and amen. Hallelujah. Once again, people of God, I welcome you into a new month. The month of favor, the month of increase, the month of greater height. This month of October, God is about to do. Sorry, this month of October, God is about to do a new thing in your life. God is about to celebrate someone. God is about to lift someone up. He said the best is kept for the ending. The best is always for the ending. Hallelujah. Praise God. Wherever you are watching me, please, I would love you to invite your loved ones to join this live service. It's going to be awesome. God is going to bless them in one way or the other. God is looking for those to lift up. God is looking for those to turn their situation around to the glory of God. Thank you, Abba Father. We bless you. We adore you. In Jesus' name. Hallelujah. Please pick your Bible quickly. Let's see what God has for us this morning. Hebrews chapter 11. Amen. Hebrews 11, verse 1 to 3. Follow me closely. He said, now faith is the substance of things hoped for, the evidence of things not seen. Please mark that word. Faith is the substance of things hoped for, the evidence of things not seen. For by it the elder obtained a good report. Through faith we understand that the world was framed by the word of God. Through faith, the world was framed by the word of God, so that the things which are seen were not made of things which do appear. Hallelujah. This morning I will be speaking on the subject understanding the practicality of it. Understanding the practicality of it. Hallelujah. Where we read, it says, faith is the substance of things hoped for, the evidence of things not seen. The evidence of things not seen. Verse 3 says, through faith we understand. That's the topic. Through faith we understand. Through faith we understand that the words were framed by the word of God, so that things which are seen were not made of things which do appear. The Bible said, by faith shall men move forward. It said, the sent as not, they are not moved by sight, rather they are moved by faith. In other words, as a child of God, as the children of God, we are not moved by what we see. We move by faith. We move by faith. He said, now faith is the substance of things hoped for. What is things hoped for? The things that is yet to come. That's faith. The things hoped for. The evidence of things not seen. In other words, the things that you are not seeing, when you have faith in it and you put it into practice, you begin to see them played out. You see them to begin to work out. A popular scripture in the book of Genesis chapter 1 verse 3. The whole world, even here where we read in verse 3, it said the whole world was framed. The whole world was framed by the walls or by the words of God. The whole universe was being framed by the word of God. And God said, amen. God believed in his heart that when he say, God believed in his heart that when he say, by faith, all things will appear. We move out. We walk out. And he begin to say, and I've said so many things. Bible said, and God see. The first creation, it was light. Illumination. God said, let there be light. He believed in himself that when he speak, it will come into existence. And he said, let there be light. And the Bible said, without that, and there was light. Hallelujah. So people of God, when you have faith in God, then you begin to practice on that faith. It is one thing for you to have faith. It's another thing for you to practice the faith. In other words, it is another thing for you to put the faith to work. Hallelujah. You practice the faith. It is a faith that is practiced that brings manifestation. It is a faith that is being practiced that brings result. It is one thing for you to have faith. It's another thing for you to put into practice. The woman with issue of blood said to herself, if only I can see Jesus. And when I see him, I will touch the hem of his garment. That's faith. She was sick in her body. She was diagnosed of the issues of blood. Without doctor prescription, with faith, she said, when I see this man, when I see Jesus, I will not say to him, please pray for me. I will not say, please, man of God, I need this. I will not say, man of God, please do this. But if I can touch the hem of his garment, I believe and I have faith and I'm rest assured that all things will be okay. All things will be well with me. My system will be back to life, will be back to normal again. That's faith. Amen. And the Bible said, when she saw Jesus, irrespective of the crowd that was against her from coming closer to Jesus. But as she struggled, as she pressed forward, as she pushed forward, she was one-on-one with Jesus. Hallelujah. That's faith, people of God. Don't wait till something happened. Put your faith in Christ Jesus to walk, and things will begin to play out. Hallelujah. Which area of your life you are believing God manifestation, begin to put the faith of God to work. Hallelujah. Begin to put it to practice. A faith that is not practiced cannot give you results. A faith that is not practiced can never give you outstanding results. You will remain where you are until you put your faith to work. Even the Bible said, faith without work is dead. Is dead, is dead. I believe that I will be married. I believe that I will have children. I believe one time to come, my children will graduate. And yet, you are not going out. You are indoor. You believe you will marry. You believe you have children. You believe a time will come, your children will grow old. But you are indoor proclaiming. And you are not going out. Amen. Where you are indoor, a man cannot find you. A man cannot meet you, for example. A man cannot impregnate you indoor. So when you believe, then what do you need to do? You need to put it to work. In other words, you need to step out by faith. You believe, oh God, as I move out today, let the man you have designed, the man you have favored, because you said in your word that he that founded a wife founded a good thing. In other words, he that founded a woman also found a good thing. There is a good thing in me. Lord, as I'm going out now, let the man that you have favored, that you have designed to favor me, come across my way. That will lead to my marriage. That will lead to my childbearing. That's faith at work. Not you being indoor, proclaiming, confessing. You believe. It's one thing to believe. It's another thing for you to act. That's the practice. That's the practice. You practice something that you know that will develop to bring you result. It is more risk not to take a risk. Hallelujah. It's very risk not to take a risk. Don't be afraid. When you move one foot, God will move the other one. When you move a feet, God will take another one. Before you know, a thousands of many minds started with a feet. It started with just a move of a leg. When you move it, you move the other one. Before you know, you will not know when you will arrive at your destination, irrespective of the distance. I must get there. And yet, you are in one place. You are not doing anything to make sure you get there. You are not moving. You are stuck. People of God, you can't get there. Hallelujah. You can never get there. So what do you need to do? You need to take a step. You need to take a step. Little by little is what brings much. A songwriter said, a little water in a drop is what make a river. A little drop. A little. It may be little, but when God is involved, it become mighty. It become majority. It become ocean. One with God is majority. Hallelujah. Praise God. So when you are believing God for something, it's not thing to believe. It's another thing for you to act on what you believe. Hallelujah. Yet it's understanding the practicality is what put faith to work in order to achieve results. Understanding the practicality of putting faith to work in order to achieve results. Not just saying it, but put it into practice. There's something we call practical. There's something we call theory. Theory is something you read. You are just reading it. That's theory. But what a time will come, what you have read, you need to put it in practice. In other words, this time around, you will switch into action. You will switch into actions. Many people that have undergone their driving school to have their driving license, a time will come, there's something they call theory. Theory is something you are reading. It's something you are reading. You are reading it. You are reading it. You are reading it. Then a time will come, you will go for your exam, which is not called practice. It is there they will not place your hand on the steering and tell you how to place your legs on the clutch, the brake, and the throttle. And tell you, look, this is the first gear that we move. This is how you will accelerate. From one gear to gear two, from two to three. This time around is not theory, but practice. This is practical. They will be telling you, as you are moving up, focus on your front, while your hand is doing the work, and your legs. That's practice. You can go for school of theory for many years, for decades, but without you putting into practice, there's no way you can learn how to drive. There's no way you can drive successfully. So in other words, it is one thing for you to have faith in God for anything. It's another thing for you to put that faith that you have into practice. Hallelujah. Praise our Lord Jesus Christ. Amen. So you must understand that. What are the requirements for workable faith? What are the requirements for workable faith? There is a requirement for a faith that we work at. There is a requirement for a faith that we work at. Number one, a deep understanding. A deep understanding of relevant scriptures. A deep understanding of a relevant scriptures. In other words, when you find the portion that speak of what you are looking for, then begin to apply it to yourself. Begin to apply it to yourself. Hallelujah. A deeper understanding of relevant scripture. A relevant scripture. When you find it, begin to apply it to yourself. Praise God. Hallelujah. You come across a scripture and you have infirmity in your body. You are sick. And you come across a scripture that says, I will not die but live to declare the word of God. Then you apply it. You know where you personalize it. You write your name on that place. I will not die. I will not die. As you believe it and you begin to act on it, instead of just lying down in your sick bed, you move out of your sick bed. I cannot be hospitalized. I cannot be lying down for sickness. I cannot lie down for death. I refuse to be hospitalized. That is the faith that brings achievement. Hallelujah. Praise God. That is the faith that brings results. That is the faith that brings achievement. Not just proclaiming, but putting it to what? To work. Putting it to work. Understanding the practicality of faith. Understanding the practicality of what? Of faith. So you must understand that. Hallelujah. Praise God. Let me show you something in the book of Romans. Follow me closely. Romans chapter 8. Romans chapter 8. Verse 14. Hallelujah. Praise God. God is awesome. He said, for as many as are led by the Spirit of God, they are the sons of God. When you come across this scripture, for as many that is led by the Spirit of God, they are the sons of God. What do you do? Now you are not in Christ Jesus. Then you need to walk in the spirituality of our Lord Jesus Christ. You need to walk in the Spirit of God resident in you. You need to walk in the spirituality of Christ in you. Because you must understand that the spiritual is what controls the physical. Hallelujah. It is the spiritual that controls the physical. Now, as many that is led by the Spirit of God, these are the sons of God. Glory be to God. Hallelujah. In the same Romans chapter 10, let me show you a scripture. Romans chapter 10. Romans 10. Hallelujah. Verse 8. Look at what the word of God says. But what say it? The word is near thee, even in the mouth and in the heart. That is the word of faith which we preach. Verse 9. That if thou shalt confess with the mouth the Lord Jesus has yet believe in the heart that God has risen him from the dead, thou shalt be saved. Verse 10, for with the heart man believe unto righteousness, and with the mouth confession is made unto salvation. Are you seeing practicality? For you to become a Christian, it takes faith and working it out. For you to be on this line of a Christian. Number one thing is for you to believe. The number two thing is for you to walk in it. Then confession will be made unto salvation. It's one thing for you to believe. I believe. That's faith already. It's another thing for you now to walk it out, to practice that belief in you. It is what you practice that definitely comes out of your mouth. It becomes your mouth speech. Hallelujah. It becomes your words. It is that your words that now make you to be rest assured that in Christ Jesus, I am saved. Hallelujah. Praise God. That in Christ Jesus, I am saved. Romans chapter 10. Let's take it to verse 17. Verse 17. It says, so then faith cometh by hearing, and hearing the word of God. When you have faith, then you continue to hear the word of God. When you have faith in Christ Jesus, then what do you need to do? Continue to listen. Continue to feed your system. Continue to feed your belief with the word of God. Hallelujah. Just as you are doing tonight, you are feeding your system with the word of God. With the word of God, you are feeding your system. You are feeding your system with the word of God that will definitely play out. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. That will definitely what? Play out. Believing in God. He said, true words was the word framed. Through the words of God was the universe framed. Hallelujah. Let there be light. Let there be darkness. Let the light take over the day. Let the moon light take over the night. Let there be a day. Let there be a night. Amen. These are practice of faith. Not just having faith, but have it and put it to work. That it will give you achievement. Hallelujah. I believe that time is coming. I will be a owner of a company. That's a belief. What are you now doing to make sure it comes into reality? That one needs works. It needs your works. Hallelujah. This time around, this is more than your belief. It now needs your practice, which is understanding the practicality of faith. I believe that a time is coming how we have a private jet. Mm-hmm. Is a private jet bad? No, it's good. Everything that you can conceive in your heart, you believe, and by faith you begin to practice it to make it to be achieved, it can be done. God said, what I say to one, I say to all. When you profess upon yourself and you begin to walk in that prophecy, you see the manifestation. Then your prophecy is rest assured to manifestation. Hallelujah. Praise God. So you must understand all this. That is not just for you to believe. It's not just for you to have faith. But for you at the same time to walk it out. To walk it out. Now faith is the substance of things not seen. The evidence. Are you seeing it? Not the evidence. You might not see it. Because what you can see, that is not faith anymore. When you can see something and you say you have it, that's not faith anymore. Because you already achieve it. You already have it. You already have it. You are believing God for a car. And yet you don't have it. And you say, Lord, I thank you because I know I'm a car owner. That's faith. You believe. And you hope in God that you are not a car owner. Then what do you need to do? It's two things. It's either you save money for it to acquire the car, or you move out and begin to pray, Lord, put me in remembrance. Send men and women across my way to bless me with a car. It can come through anybody. God can use anybody to bless you with a car. Are you hearing me? God can use anybody to favor you with a car. That's practice. It's either you save money and acquire the and purchase the car and you acquire it, or you put it in prayer, Lord, send favor to me. Let somebody bless me with car. It's possible. With God, the Bible says all things are possible with God, it's possible. God can use anybody to be a favor to you. God can use anybody to be a blessing to you. God can use anybody to favor you. Depends the way you walk out your faith. Depends on the way you walk out your faith. It is the walking out of your faith that bring your achievement, that bring your manifestation. Hallelujah. Praise God. It is walking out of your faith that brings your manifestation. Amen. Hallelujah. Ephesians chapter 5. Let me show you something. Ephesians chapter 5. Let's consider verse 26. See what God says. Ephesians chapter 5, verse 26. That he might sanctify it, having cleansed it by the washing of water with the word. He's talking about purity now. He's talking about you being baptized. Hallelujah. About baptism. That he might sanctify, that God might sanctify you. Satisfy you. Having cleaned it by the washing of water with what? With words. Hallelujah. Praise God. He said, the word I speak unto you, they are spirit and they are life. When the word of God comes into your life, it becomes a living stuff. It become a living thing inside you. The spirit. The word I speak unto you, they are spirit and they are life. When the word of God comes in you, it wake your inner mind. It wake your inner man. It wake your spirituality. Hallelujah. Praise God. So it wakes it up. It wakes it up. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. So what does that mean? You must understand that your faith, it need the practice. It need your practice to make it work out. It need your practice to make it work out. What are the requirements for workable faith? Number two, possessing the faith mindset. Possessing the faith mindset. Hallelujah. You possess the faith of your mindset. You possess the faith of your mindset. Hallelujah. Praise God. Possessing the faith. You have a mindset. You have a mindset. You possess it. You possess it. Hallelujah. Praise God. You possess it. It's something you possess. Hallelujah. Praise God. So, people of God, you need to possess your faith by your mindset. I will not die prematurely. That is a mindset. Before 19 December, I will be twice richer than where I am now. That's a mindset. That's a mindset. That's a mindset. You are putting your what you have configured in you into practice that will finally give you an achievement. You have faith. That's good. Then you must put the mindset to work. Hallelujah. Praise God. You must put it to work. To work. Listen, if you are not like him, it is impossible to think like him. Talking about Jesus. If you are not like him, it is impossible to walk like him. He said, let this man be in you, which also was in Christ Jesus. Let this man be in you, which was also in Christ Jesus. In Philippians chapter 1, verse 5, Jesus was speaking. He said, let this man is a mindset. Is a mindset. Let it be in you, which is also in Christ Jesus. What made the ministration of Jesus outstanding? What made the ministry of Jesus to be outstanding? It was his mindset. What does that mean, Pastor? What are you saying? Make me to understand. In other words, you don't think like others. Amen. You don't do things like others. You think differently from others. Amen. In many occasions, Jesus put his mindset to work and he bring him results. Like our previous message, last week, the Bible said Jesus went to the mountain to go and pray. In the evening, when it was dark, he went to the cellar. None of them were there. All of them has gone. No ship to take him to the other side. And his disciples have already left him to wait for him on the other side. What did he do? He knew that with God, all things are possible. He put his mindset to work. And the Bible said, he began to walk on the water. Hallelujah. He began to do what? To walk on the water. Mindset. Possessing the faith mindset. There was a time, the Bible said, Jesus was in the boat with his disciples. And the wind was contrary, was boasting. That even the ship was almost to capsize, was almost to sink. What Jesus did? The Bible said, he went to sleep. Amen. He was sleeping. In other words, he knew that because he's here, he can't die. He can't just die. Let the wind take the ship upward and break it down. You know he can't die. He can't die. Until he fulfills his ministry, he can't die. So when you have this mindset that you can't, you think differently from others. You can't. There are certain things that can just happen to you because of who you are. Because of the revelation of what you have known about Jesus. You don't fear like others. Amen. COVID-19 is taking life, is killing. Thousands is lying down in the hospital. That not me. Not me. Because before he can come to me, let it first of all go and kill Jesus. If Jesus can be hospitalized and is in the hospital and they begin to fist drip and begin to treat him, then it may be applicable to me. But if our Lord Jesus Christ cannot be on the sick bed, then I cannot be on the sick bed. Amen. I don't know how many years I visited hospital, except for some of my members. Some of our members in the church that give birth. Hallelujah. Not for me to go there, or you hear that the pastor is sick, or pastor have an accident. Hallelujah. His legs, his hand is broken. He can't. The word of God said his bone was not broken. So my whole boat cannot be broken. Hallelujah. Praise God. So it's a mindset. There must be a mindset you carry that will prevent some certain things to happen to you. That will still prevent some certain things not to happen to you. Hallelujah. Praise God. I can do all things through Christ that strengthens me. That is a scripture mindset. That is a scripture mindset. That you can do exceedingly abundantly is a mindset. That when others are afraid, you are at peace. Is a mindset. Amen. Is a mindset. When tribulation arises, I refuse to be troubled. I refuse to be worried. Jesus have taken care of my tribulation. Is a mindset. Amen. Is a mindset. Amen. I may not have food to eat now. There is nothing absolutely at home. But I know by this time tomorrow, there will be surplus. It's a mindset. Amen. He's a what? He's a mindset. So you must understand what I'm telling you, people of God. Possessing the faith mindset. Hallelujah. In my family, nobody have done this. But with my mindset, I can do it. That's a mindset. And you walk it out. And you walk it out. You stood out. Becomes a blessing. Many times in my life, God have used me to do what has not been done in my family. Why? Because I believe in God and in my mindset. God, this thing may not have happened in my family, but through me, it can't work out. That's a mindset. Amen. That's a mindset. Listen, people of God. It talking about mindset, it will take mindset for someone to remain in abject poverty. Amen. It takes a mindset for someone to break out of poverty. Amen. Hallelujah. It takes what? A mindset for someone to be out of poverty. And it takes a mindset for someone to remain in abject poverty. The choice is yours. Amen. The choice is what? It's yours. When Jesus was around, the Bible said Jesus was doing good. He was doing good. All sort of good. Blessing people. Anywhere he go, they were singing with his name. But a time came that a woman called Mary came and broke the alabaster box of oil in the feet of Jesus. And Judas Iscariot was grumbling and said, what a waste. This oil should have been sold and take the money back to the church account. And Jesus looked at him and shook his head. He said, the poor you will always have among you, but me you will not have always. Hallelujah. In other words, Jesus was trying to make them to understand there are people that have placed themselves to remain in poverty, and there's nothing anybody can do about that. There's nothing. Amen. There's nothing. Even though you try to help them, they can't help themselves. They can't help themselves. I remember one of my daughters in the Lord then, in our ministry. She was very pregnant, almost to give birth. And I went to pray for her. He said, Pastor, the daughter told me that I'm going to give birth through operation. I said, God forbid. God forbid. You will not give birth through operation. I strongly believe that you will give birth smoothly. Do you know what she said to me? She said, Pastor, he said, and I just know I will give birth by operation. I just know, I believe that it's through operation. Pastor, don't worry. I said, no, you can't. He said, I'm telling you. And she began to give me reason. He said, my first child, it was through operation. And my second child is through operation. Even my third child, through operation. So this is the fourth one, Pastor. So I believe the daughter that I'm going to give birth through operation. And even the daughter said that I might lose my life. I said, you can't lose your life. That is why I'm here. That's why I'm here. As long as you're a member of our ministry, no one die prematurely. Or turning death is not our portion. You can't die. You can't die. He said, Pastor, I believe you that I cannot die. I will not die. But I believe I'm going to give birth by operation. Jesus said, without your mind, I can do nothing. Without your mind, I can do nothing. Because she strongly believed that it's through operation. Then, she gave birth through operation. But the good news was that she didn't die in giving birth through operation in the fourth time. Because that one, I resisted. My spirit fought that. And she believed on that I believe you, I will not die. But to that operation, Pastor, forget. And just know it's operation. Then I said, let it be unto you according to your faith. Let it be unto you according to your faith. Hallelujah. Praise God. So people of God, you must understand that your faith that works out is a responsibility of your mindset. It's something you have taken over time. It's something that is in you that you have worked on for many, many times, many years, that will eventually play out for you. That it become your mindset that work out for you. Hallelujah. Praise God. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Proverbs chapter 23. Let me show you something. Proverbs 23. Verse 7. Let's look at what the word of God said. It said, for as man thinketh in his heart, so he is. For as a man thinketh in his heart, so he is. So in other words, you are the reflection of what is in your heart. You are the reflection of what is what? In your heart. Hallelujah. The reflection of what is in your heart. You reflect what you have kept in your heart. Amen. The reflection of what is in your heart. As a man thinketh in his heart, so he is. As he thinketh. So the question is, what are you thinking? How are you working at your faith? How is you? How are you practicing the faith of Christ in your life? As a man thinketh in his heart, so he is. Possessing the faith mindset. Amen. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. So there are some certain things you understand within you that played out in you because of your mindset. Because of your mindset. Let this mind be in you, which we are also in Christ Jesus. Hallelujah. Let this mind be in you, which we are also in Christ Jesus. Hallelujah. Praise God. Let it be in you. Let it always be in you. Always, always. Scripture number 2. Praise God. 2 Corinthians chapter 10. 2 Corinthians 10. Verse 3 to 4. Look at this. He said, for though we walk in the flesh, for though we walk in the flesh, we do not war according to the flesh. For though we walk in the flesh, we do not war accordingly to the flesh. Or irrespective that you are fleshly, you are putting on flesh, is making you to understand there is a mindset, there is a spirit of God in you. Amen. Verse 4 says, for the weapon of our warfare are not carnal. For the weapon of our warfare are not of. For the weapon of our warfare are not of the flesh, but mighty before God to the throwing down of stronghold. This NIV version. King James version said, for the pulling down of stronghold. For we wrestle. Amen. Although we are in the flesh, but we war not against the flesh. Amen. We war not against the flesh. So it is your mindset of what you know that eventually bring you out. Praise God. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. So you and I must understand what it takes, what is involved. If your faith must be alive, then there is the need for you to work it out. Then there must be a need of practice that will bring the achievement. Hallelujah. Praise God. Understanding the practicality of faith is something you must understand. That before your faith can be outstanding, it can work out for you, it can bless you, then there's a need for you to practice it, to put it to work. Hallelujah. Praise God. There's a need for you to put it to what? To work. Then you will begin to play the heart. Hallelujah. Praise God. So do not always look at the scenario as what is happening. No. Always look at what is in you. The capacity in you. The mindset of Christ Jesus in you. That can work all things out for good. That can work all things out for good. Hallelujah. Praise God. Don't say it is over until you win. It is never over until you win. Hallelujah. Praise God. I make you to understand that except you begin to think like him, then there's no way you can walk like him. There's no way you will look like him. When you have the mindset of our Lord Jesus Christ, again, you'll begin to function like him. You'll begin to move like him. Hallelujah. You'll begin to act like him. Praise God. May God bless his word in our hearts in Jesus' name. So, people of God, I challenge you tonight. Don't just be a Christian, but be a Christian with a different. A Christian that is alive is upgrading, is working out by the faith of our Lord Jesus Christ in you. Don't just let the faith die. Work it out. When we read, it says faith, we work faith. Faith cometh by hearing, and hearing with the word of God. When you want to build up your faith, you begin to walk in the word of God and begin to act on it. Before you know, your faith will be built up. Hallelujah. May God bless his word in our heart in Jesus' name. People of God, where you are, I pray for you this hour. Wherever your faith is dead, in the name of Jesus, I call it back to life. Every dead faith, Lord, I speak life into it now. Let there be a restoration of dead faith in the name of Jesus Christ. Let your peace that pass all understanding begin to play out in their life in the name of Jesus Christ. Wherever you are, my God will bless you and keep you in the name of Jesus. We have come to the ending of today's service. God has been awesome. God is a blessing. People of God, wherever you are, I pray for you that this month of October will favor you. This month of October will celebrate you in the name of Jesus Christ. Men and women will come unto you, because whom the Lord has blessed, no man can curse. So this month have no other reason than to work out for your good, than to bless you in the name of Jesus Christ. Father, we thank you, we bless you. We lift your name higher, we celebrate you. Thank you for starting with us well, and thank you, O God, for closing with us well. Jehovah said, Jehovah Yare, wherever we are, wherever your children may be, Lord, I pray for them. This year, we bring their achievement as they walk out their faith in the name of Jesus Christ. Lord, we thank you, we bless you. Glory, glory, honor will be ascribed unto you forevermore. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Let's share the grace together. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the sweet fellowship of the Holy Spirit rise and bow with us now, forever and ever. Amen. Surely, may your goodness and mercy follow us all the days of our lives, and we shall dwell in the house of the Lord forever and ever. Amen. People of God, for more contribution, if you want to support us, if you want to get more information, or pay us, you need our prayer, please contact us. 632-646-479. We will attend to you and we'll give you listening ear. May God bless you and keep you in Jesus' name. Or you can even WhatsApp us with that line. 632-646-479. It is well with you. It is well with your body. It is well with your soul. In Jesus' name. Have a happy, stressful week. In Jesus' name. Amen.